Hey, good morning, everybody. How we doing? I'm Kat with Good Shepherd Health and Fitness today. Can you hear me? Is anybody out there? Can you hear me? Hello. I hope you can. I'm using a microphone today. I'm hoping that the sound is a little better. Okay, so once again, hello. My name is Kat. Welcome to Good Shepherd's Health and Fitness Center. Yay, can you guys hear me? I'm using a microphone today. If somebody can just give me a thumbs up and let me know, or if you can hear me. Hello, hello. Becky and Timothy, hello. Thank you for joining. So nice to have you guys here today, this Monday morning after Thanksgiving. Hopefully we didn't eat too much, or you guys had some walks in or some exercise this weekend. Maybe some yoga with me. I did an energizing sequence on Saturday. And today, I thought we'll do some stretching. Nice little late morning stretch. And of course, you could always watch this later on in the day. Let me see if I could see comments here. Did anybody comment? Letting me know. I'm not finding any comments. Okay, well, I will just continue and hope that you are hearing me, since I'm not hearing and seeing anybody. Let me know. So let's start out with a little centering. I invite you to come to the floor on your mats. Some props that would be helpful for you today would be a strap for sure. You do have some sort of a strap. If you don't have a strap, a belt from a robe are long. They're longer than those leather straps that we wear around our pants. Also an electric cord, one of the shorter ones that you're using for Christmas, that could help be helpful as well. Somebody commenting, I think. Let me just see. All right. Good, thank you, Becky. Thank you for letting me know that you can hear me. Okay, and then of course, blocks. I always tell you that blocks are great to have if you don't have any blocks. These are really good ones. They're thicker. You'll see at Target, sometimes those thinner ones, I really think these are better. So if you are ever planning on getting blocks for yourselves, two is better than one, and the thicker ones are better as well. Great, thank you so much for letting me know again about the sound. Okay, so blocks, straps. Again, I have my bells today for you guys for later on to come out of our Shavasana relaxation pose. So hopefully you'll hang out throughout the whole class and you can get the benefits of the entire class today. Welcome once again, my name is Kat, Facebook Live here for Good Shepherd Health and Fitness Center here in Barrington, Illinois. Really happy to have you, really happy to have this opportunity to do this Facebook Live for you guys. We need our yoga, and I'm glad to be here, and I'm glad that you're here to join me. Let's start out in a comfortable seated position for our centering pose. So if you're comfortable cross-legged, that's fine. You can bring your legs in front of you. You can sit on a block, you can sit on a pillow. So whatever's comfortable for you, as long as your spine is nice and long, okay? We don't want a slouch spine. So sometimes when we're cross-legged, it's hard to keep that spine tall. So again, do the best you can. Lengthening through the crown of the head, relaxing the shoulders back, lifting up, pressing the sit bones down, hands gently on either knee. Go ahead and close your eyes. We'll take these few moments to turn our eyes inward. Feel free to take a few deep breaths in and out of your nose. Clearing your minds of the thoughts from earlier today. Just allowing your bodies to settle into the space that it's in. Bringing our full body, soul, breath, this very present moment. Noticing our breath as it flows gently in and out of our nose. just noticing the coolness of the breath as it enters your nose, and the warmth of the breath as it exits your nose. Allowing the belly and chest to rise with each inhalation and fall with each exhalation. Now I invite you to take a moment to set an intention for yourself. This could be an intention for your practice, an intention for the day, maybe an intention for the whole week, a goal, a mantra, a prayer, or dedication. And once you have set your intention, take a deep breath in through your nose. Hold or pause the breath for about 5 to 10 seconds. And then exhale completely. Returning back to a regular breath.
For your safety, please note the presence of our team as these areas are clean. Thank you. Team, please meet on the fitness floor.
Okay, bow your heads down to the earth in gratitude. Gently open your eyes and inhale your heads up. All right, you might have heard that announcement. I am in the club and the club is open. We are just not holding live classes here, but as you can see, they didn't realize I was doing a live class right now, so it's all good. Let's do some breathing. I think it's really important to do a little breath work, especially in the beginning of the week. I really like to do breath work every day, but if we could do some alternate nasal breathing, something that maybe some of you are not familiar with. So what I'm gonna have you do, come a little closer so you can see. I'm gonna have you take your hand, your right hand, and I'd like you to take these two fingers, your thumb and your ring finger, okay? So these two fingers, you'll be squeezing your nose. All right? The other two fingers you can either place on the third eye or you can tuck underneath, all right? So we're gonna be alternating the breath between one nostril and the other nostril. And what this does is it balances our energies. I don't know if you know, but we only breathe through one nostril or the other nostrils through different parts of the day, and that affects our energy, our masculine and feminine energy. So the right side of our body is more masculine, the left side is more feminine, and what I mean by that is we have more of a stronger, more creative influence on the left side, and more stronger, more analytical influence on the right side. So those are what some of the differences between the energy. But in general, we want that balanced. So let's take a moment and do a little pranayama breathing. So placing the finger on your nose, we'll inhale through the left nostril. Close that left nostril, and then exhale through the right nostril. Inhale through the right nostril. Close the nostrils, exhale through the left. Long, deep breath. Close the nostrils, long exhalation. Once again, one long deep breath. Close the nostrils, exhale. Continue breathing, inhale. Balancing our energy, exhale. Moving at your own pace. after you've done one nostril. Go ahead and release the hand. Take a deep breath through both nostrils. Hold it. And then exhale completely. Returning back to a regular breath. All right, so you may or may not find any immediate changes or benefits, but the longer you do it, 1 to 3 minutes for your alternate nasal breath, the more benefits that you will find. Coming back into my cross-legged position, let's move our head to the right and left, a little warming up. Inhale, heads to the right, over the shoulder. Exhale, back to center. Inhale, heads to the left, look over your shoulder. And exhale, back to center. Then look up and back. And exhale, chin to chest. Returning your head back to center. Releasing the head to the right. So just ear to shoulder. Go ahead and reach that same arm over the head and allow the weight of the forearm to release over the head to release the neck. Go ahead and release the opposite arm out to the side. Nice and gentle. If you've been working all morning at your desk, this will feel nice. Inhale your arm up. Exhale the arm back down. We'll do the same thing on the other side. Release the head to the side. Opening up the right side of the head, neck. Then reach up through the left arm, overhead. Release. Deep breaths. Always focusing, being aware, paying attention on your breath. Inhale, arm up. Exhale, arm down. Good. Let's warm up the shoulders. Reach arms up. Deep breath. Hands to the heart. Inhale, straight up. Exhale, arms to the earth. Once again, deep breath. Look up. Hands to the heart. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, arms to the earth. Side stretches, reaching the right arm up, deep breath. Walk the other hand out to the side, bend the elbow and reach. Hello, everybody, welcome. Happy Monday. Today we're gonna do a nice stretch yoga. Breathing, lengthening, breathing. Inhale up and release the arm. Other side, take a deep breath. Walk the fingertips out, release the shoulder, reach. Breathe with the side body, slight rotation upward. Keeping the shoulder away from the ear. Long deep breaths, all the way back up. Now let's reach those arms to the sides. We'll add a twist. Deep breath. Exhale to the right. Inhale back. All the way to the other side. And exhale back to center. Okay, same thing the other way. So we'll inhale first. Exhale, twist. Inhale to the other side. And then exhale back to center. Okay? Inhale, exhale, twist, look over your shoulder. Inhale, all the way to the other side. And exhale, back to center. Reach the arms overhead. Clasp your hands, and let's bring them behind the back of the neck. Head up, nice little shoulder stretch. Reaching in, palms to the sky. Reaching the arms forward in front of you. Rounding your upper back. So I'm pushing back to the upper back, pushing the hands forward, and inhaling back up. So So I'm rolling back to my tailbone and then lifting up. Exhale, round. Inhale, up. And again, round. And back up. Good. Reach the arms overhead. Exhale, arms to the sides. And let's clasp the hands behind your back. Roll the shoulders back. Lift the heart. And bring those arms back to the sides. Okay, a little bit more chest and arm work. Bringing the fingertips together like you're a Mamma Mia Pizzeria mama, Italian mother, about to cook. Elbows into the sides of the body, okay? Shoulders back. And I invite you to release the arms back as you lift up, opening the front of the body. And then as you exhale, bring the hands together, elbows still stay in, and round. Inhale, look up. Exhale, round. Inhale, look up. Exhale, round. Once again, up. And round. Good. And then we turn back to center. Nice little upper body work. Let's grab our strap. Hopefully everybody's got something that they can grab. You know, you can even grab a shirt, you know, or a sock. So we want it to be longer if possible. So we're just gonna do some stretching, reaching up overhead. Notice I stretch my legs out in front of me, so feel free to, or you can keep them crossed, doesn't matter, as long as the spine is right. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. So just to the point of tension, again, up. And back down. Okay, last time, we're gonna go all the way up, and this time I'd like you to spread the arms until you can release them all the way behind you. Once again, up, exhale down. Walk the hands in towards each other, maybe about a half an inch at most. Up overhead, straight arms back. Inhale, up, exhale forward. Once again, in towards each other a little bit, not too far, take a deep breath. Back, inhale. And exhale. Good. All right, grab that strap again a little closer, shoulder width apart, reach overhead. Bring the one arm next to the ear. So we're pulling the strap over next to the ear. Then bend that elbow behind the head. Now I'm going to slide my hand down the strap. All right, bring that arm behind your back. I'm pulling the arm, opening up this tricep here. So I'm still holding onto the strap, pulling it down, lifting up, breathing. Then I'll release the strap, the lower strap, flip the hand backwards, grab the strap behind you, and walk the hands towards each other, pushing the hand into the lower spine or into the middle spine, wherever you can reach, walking the upper hand towards the lower hand, breathing deeply. Head is up. Gaze is forward. Relax your jaws, your throats. Long, deep breaths. Go ahead and release the bottom hand from the strap. Reach the arms out to the sides. Push. Flip the palms up all the way. Notice I still have the strap in my hand. Go ahead and grab the strap. So again, shoulder width apart. This time, other arm next to the ear. Okay. Arms going behind my head, okay, best you can. Notice this hand, make it a little bit of fluffy so that you can release the arm behind your back. Slide the hand down the strap, pull it. Relax the shoulder, lift the heart. Breathe deeply, stretching the tricep. And then go ahead and release the strap on that lower hand. Flip the palm backwards, bend the elbow, and grab that strap behind you, walking the hands towards each other. You might have to look down for a moment, but then lift up. Walk those hands towards each other. Long, deep breaths. Relax your jaws, your throats, your facial muscles. Breathe deeply. Let it go. Let go any stress that you may have in those shoulders and in the neck. Release the bottom hand. Take a deep breath. Arms out. Go ahead and release that strap down to the floor. Just move it away. Flip the palms up. And let's bring those hands all the way forward. Give one more twist. Take a deep breath. Exhale, twist to the side. Move the shoulder. Inhale all the way to the other side. Exhale back. Same thing on the other side. Inhale. Exhale, twist. Look over the shoulder. Inhale to the other side. And exhale back to center. Good. All right, let's bring those legs in front of us. And we're gonna work on our hips a little bit. So let's first do another twist, all right? This will open up the hip and add a little twist to our thoracic spine. So bend one knee. Bring it as close to the body as comfortable, as long as that spine is erect. Hand over the knee, the other hand behind you. Fingertips facing backwards. Roll the shoulder back, lift the heart, take a deep breath. And then twist a little further. You can bring that leg a little closer if you'd like. For those of you who feel comfortable enough, wrap your arm a little tighter around the knee. Long, deep breaths. Inhale, your head's forward. Exhale, untwist. Now keeping that knee bent, I'm gonna bring you, have you bring your opposite hand to the side of the body and face forward again. So bring your hand to the side of the body, that same knee is bent. Bring your elbow inside the knee and the hand on the outside of the foot. Now some of you, if you have your strap, use your strap, okay? That's an option as well. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna lift that leg up. Notice again, elbows inside the knee. The knee is gonna go outside the shoulder as I pull it back. So this movement is called bow and arrow. It's a really good hip opener. So again, elbow inside, hand outside, foot is flexed, hand supports you. Lift the leg up, pull your leg back, opening up the hip, nice straight spine, and then push, using my foot to push my arm forward. I'm stretching my spine. Pull your leg back, inhale. Exhale, push forward, bow and arrow, pulling my elbow back, and then shooting my arrow forward. Inhale, opening up that hip, exhale. Okay, let's bring it all the way back, lift it, and let's balance, reach the opposite arm out. Nice straight spine, lifting through the crown of the head, tight, nice and tall. If you like it, can go ahead, straighten that leg, lifting it out to the side. Exhale, hand to foot, or hand to shin, or hand to thigh. Exhale, bend the knee. Alright, we're gonna externally rotate that leg for our forward bend. So go ahead and rotate the body so it's facing that leg. And if you have a strap and you want to use a strap, around the ball mount of the toe, all right? Not the middle of the foot, but the ball mount of the toe. That way you can really push out. You want to lengthen, keep that tall body, and then bring the belly towards the thigh. If you don't have a strap, just bring the fingertips to the floor. Lengthen as you inhale. Lead with the belly towards the thigh, chest towards the knee, walking the hands toward forward. And moving slowly, lengthening as you inhale, feeling the lengthening of the side body, exhaling down towards the leg. Lengthen as you inhale, and release. Feel free to reach the opposite arm of the leg forward, grabbing shin, ankle, or foot. Releasing the head towards the knee, breathing long, deep breaths into your back bodies. And we're just going to come up halfway, a little lengthening. Inhale, look up. Exhale, down. A little further, deepen. Both feet on both hands, or both hands on both feet if you'd like. Okay, when you're ready, hands to the floor. Inhale, walk your hands up. Let's bring that knee in and slide the leg forward to meet the other. Back to your staff pose. And let's twist on the other side first. So we're going to bend that knee, opposite knee. Hand around the knee, opposite arm behind you. Roll the shoulder back, take a deep breath. Exhale, twist. Lengthen through the heel, bring that leg closer if you'd like. Hug the leg tighter if you'd like. Long, deep breaths. When you're ready, inhale, heads forward. Exhale, untwist. We're going to bring that other hand to the side of the body. That same leg is still bent. Bring the elbow inside the knee. Flex the foot, hand outside the foot. Nice straight spine. Lift the leg up. Pull that leg back. And then shoot the leg forward. Inhale, open the heart. Exhale, fold forward. Stretching your back body. Inhale, pull your foot. Exhale, lengthen. Inhale, and exhale. Good. Inhale, and exhale. Okay, last time, let's pull it back. Hold on to that foot. Reach the opposite arm out. Lift through the crown of the head. If you'd like, straighten that leg best you can. Exhale, hand to foot, or hand to calf, or ankle, or thigh, or whatever you can reach. Lift it, bend the knee inside the inner groin, and then externally rotate. Bring your body so it's facing that leg, so you're facing the lengthened leg. Again, use your strap if you'd like. I'll use it this time. Demonstration purposes. And we're going to lengthen as we inhale. And pull that strap towards you, belly towards the thigh. Take your time. Take another deep breath. Continue releasing. And maybe this is it for you, and that's fine. Just breathe. Let go. Relax the head. Breathe into your back bodies. If you'd like, reach forward further with your hand. Let's inhale halfway, look up, deep breath. And then back down. A little deeper. Long, deep breaths. Ready, inhale up through the head, nice and tall. And then go ahead, you're using a strap, remove it, bring that knee up, and we go feet forward. Getting a good stretch through those legs this weekend, or this morning, after this weekend. All right, feet are parallel, full Paschimottanasana, forward bend. So if you need knees bent a little bit, you know, feel free to, because a forward bend is more about your back body. It's more about bringing breath to the back body. So if you happen to have a block or two, you can also use those under the knees. All right, so that's an option if you have tight hamstrings. You don't have to keep those and then be like this. We really want to bring our belly towards the thigh and then fold forward. So I'm going to demonstrate with the block. Keeping the knees slightly bent. Take a deep breath, and again, you can use your strap as well. Inhaling as you lengthen through the crown of the head. And then bring that belly towards the thigh. Baby steps. Lengthen as you inhale. And release as you exhale. Keeping the shoulders wide. Chest is open. Lengthen as you inhale. Fold forward as you exhale. Long, deep breaths into your back body. Fold forward. For those of you who want to, bring your hands to your shins, ankles, or feet, allowing the head to fall between the shoulders towards the knees. Breathe, let go. Nice relaxing pose, really, really brings breath into your backs. Okay, halfway again, inhale up, halfway, look. Exhale back down. A few more breaths in this forward bend. And then bring your fingertips or hands to the floor and slowly, leading with the head, walk it up. So coming up with a flat back. Back to your staff pose. Okay, let's lengthen up through the arms. Deep breath up. Nice long spine. Exhale, arms down. All right, let's open up those hips and try a little bit more balancing, a little balancing bear pose. So, opens up the hips a little bit more by bending the knees to the sides of the body. Do the best you can. Flex your feet onto the heels. Bring the arms inside the knees like we did before, and the hands outside the feet. If this is not going to work for you, just grab the shins or even just the thighs. All right? So, this is an option. This is an option. Or this is an option. One leg up, pulling it back like we did in our bow and arrow. And then the other leg up. And then both. So this is tricky. So you could potentially fall back. So do the best you can by using your core, by lifting up, using the back body, pulling the knees towards you. Again, your hands can be here. Breathe deeply. Balancing there. If you'd like, straighten the legs. A little bit more challenging. Nice long spine through the crown of the head. Deep breaths. Exhale, feet together. So hands can either stay on the feet, or if you need to, drop them down to the shins or thighs. Then bend the knees. All right, going into our boat pose. So I'm going to scoot sideways. Keep your legs lifted. Legs are lifted. If you need to bring the hands to the thighs, that's fine. Pull the belly in. Bring the arms forward. Breathe. Inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, back down. Another deep breath up. And back to the earth. Good. Now widen the legs. We're bringing the arms inside the knees and then outside the knees. Inside the knees and then outside the knees. Keep breathing. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Good. Last time, both legs and both arms up. Nice, tall, best you can. If you need to support yourself, feel free to. Otherwise, reach through the fingertips, reach through the crown. Boat pose. Exhale. Woo. Bend the knees. All right. Let's come onto our hands and knees and release that spine in our cat-cow pose. Coming onto your hands and knees, spread those hands. Ground them firmly. Knees are hip width apart. Alright, so don't squeeze those knees together. Bring them apart. Not too wide either. So under your hips. Grounding and arching when you're ready. Round as you exhale. Arch as you inhale. Round as you exhale. And arch. Cow pose, pushing the floor away from you, grounding, tailbone under, and arch. Good. Last one. And arch. Moving into puppy dog pose, So that's a cross between child and dog pose. Fingertips down. Curl the toes under. Lengthen through the spine. So we're not quite relaxed. We're making a long spine, but we're not in a full downward dog. Inhale up. Now let's come into some lunges. So if you need blocks, feel free to use them. Otherwise, just bring one leg forward, fingertips to the floor, or on your blocks. And just opening up those hips, bringing the hips forward. So the front knee forward, space between the front foot and back knee. Pressing back through the back knee, let's bring the hand to the thigh, sweep the arm up to the sky. Exhale, inhale, other arm up. And hands to the heart. Twisting, we're gonna reach one arm forward and the other arm back. So I'm gonna twist towards the bent knee. Reach, pressing back through the foot for balance. Reach, exhale back. Let's do that again. Inhale, reach. Exhale back. Ooh, so you really got to press through that front foot and back foot. One last time. Inhale, reach. Opposite arm. Exhale. Good. Reach all the way up. Release the arms into a goddess position. Open the chest. Then release the arms behind your back. Clasp your hands. Roll the shoulders back. Lift the heart. Hips forward. Exhale, forward fold. Release the head to the floor. Nice little back stretch. And release the hands back to your blocks or floor. Slide the leg back. And let's bring the other leg forward. I'm going to do this one this time sideways so you can see better. So we're in our lunge. Bring that front knee. You want to make sure the knee is not behind the ankle, but rather over the ankle or slightly in front of it. Spread the toes, ground the foot, bring the hand to the knee, and then reaching one arm up, pressing back from the back foot, and then the other arm up. Deep breaths. Really leaning, a little back bending here too. Hips protruding forward gently. Hands to the heart, and now we twist towards the leg. Inhale, twist. Breathe. Exhale back. Once again, reach. And back. Good. Last time. Inhale. And exhale. Reach the arms overhead. Goddess pose, elbows out or goalpost position. Hands behind the back, clasp the hands, roll the shoulders back, lift up. And release the arms back to the floor. Slide that leg back, and let's move into our downward dog. So on your hands and knees, spread your hands, curl the toes under, lift the hips off the floor, or knees off the floor, and lengthen through the spine. Nice and long. Here we can walk our doggies. Right here, left heel. I'm gonna talk a little softer because this thing is right in my speaker, is right in my face. Just getting used to the speaker here on my. Let me know how it sounds, guys. Okay, both heels up, both heels down, and then go ahead and walk those feet forward. Coming into a forward bend. Release here, let it go. Shake your head out. Hands to the hips, let's push back, lift up. Nice tall spines. All right, so see I have my speaker right here. So when I'm upside down, how you guys doing, okay? Everybody good? All right. Let's walk. Come into a warrior pose, all right? So 1 foot forward, 1 foot back. Pushing the feet. Actually, my apologies. Let's come into a, not a warrior, but rather a crescent pose where I'm bending the heel and bending down. All right, so similar to that low lunge, but it's more of a high end lunge. Deep breath up. Hips towards the earth. Hands to the heart. And then I invite you to come into a balancing pose. So we're just going to bring both legs forward and come into a gentle balancing pose. Maybe you can go further, great. If not, as far as you can go for your warrior three. Bending the knee, bringing that toe back to the floor, reach the arms overhead again. Exhale, bend the elbows out, goddess. Release the arms back, clasp your hands, roll the shoulders back, and let's fold forward. A little challenging here on your toe. Release the arms, back foot forward, forward bend. Hands to the hips, all the way up. All right, so we'll do that same thing on the other side. Just walk the other leg back on your toe. All right, hips down, tailbone under, belly in. Sweep the arms overhead. Exhale, hips down, bend the knees. Push the feet away from each other like you're spreading the mat with the feet. So we're getting a nice stretch in that quad, in that buttock area as you push your feet apart. Really lengthen. Hands together to the heart. Roll the shoulders back, gazes forward, coming into that balancing pose. Warrior three. Feel free to reach the arms back to the sides like an airplane or forward. And then just come back to that toe. Whew. Reach up, bend the elbows out. Reach back, clasp your hands, roll back, and fold forward. Head towards the ground, relax the head completely. Nice stretch to that back. Bring the hands to the floor, or your blocks, feet together, forward bend. Hands to the hips, push back, lift up, nice flat back. Do a little external rotation by walking your feet apart, toes are outward. All right, bend your knees. Continue bringing your heels in towards me, towards the camera. Down to the hips, tailbone under. Let's bring the arms forward and out. Forward and out. Exhale and inhale. Exhale. And inhale. Flip the palms up, reach overhead, and down to the earth. Once again, inhale. Hands together to the heart. A little deeper. Once again, arms, just the arms up. Exhale, gold pose position. Good. Deep breath. Twist to one side. Inhale back. Exhale to the other side. Inhale back. Good. Reach arms out. Let's reach to the right. Reach to the left. Inhale right. Exhale left. Inhale right. Exhale left. Good. Reach. Notice my legs are not moving, just my torso. Reach. Reach. Breathe. And lengthen. Good. A couple more. Good, back to center. Reach arms overhead and hands to the heart. Good, straighten all the way up. Release the arms down. Let's bring our toes inward, heels out. So now the opposite, fold forward. Take a deep breath. Exhale, fold forward. Another deep breath. Continuing down to the ground, head towards the earth. Relax the head completely, shake it out. There's my face again next to the, Okay, hands to the floor. One hand in the middle, the other hand to your hip. Okay, we're gonna rotate as we push the hand down. Rotate the shoulder open. Reach through the arm to the sky. Nice little twist for the upper body again. Breathe. Exhale, arm over here. Then chest to the ground and hand to the ground. We'll do the same thing on the other side. One hand down, the other hand to the hip. Rotate open. Keep pushing down as we keep rotating that shoulder towards the sky. Grounding through the feet. Reach the arm up. Deep breaths. Exhale, untwist. All right, feel free to walk your feet in towards each other a little bit. Knees slightly bent, hands to the hips. Let's come flat back up. Back into our mount pose. All right, let's release to the floor. Let's continue with some more stretching on the floor. We'll come all the way down. Let's come onto our knees, hands and knees. We'll do a little pigeon pose, okay? So this is where you may need a block for your hips. So a couple of different options here. One option is to just bring one knee forward and just relax in this position. This might be it for some of you. And you might be able to come down to the elbows. All right? If you can externally rotate that leg, what I mean by that is by bringing that knee forward and then bringing the leg up the side, feel free to. This is where you can also use one of those blocks underneath your hip for support. And again, that's just an option. All right, if you have it, you can just have it hang there, but you can have a pillow also under that hip. I have kind of tight hips, so I'm a really good example for using props under the hip. All right, so coming to the fingertips to lengthen first, and then when you're ready, come forward to the hands, drop down to your elbows, and if you have two blocks, you can rest one head on a block. Long deep breaths and long exhalations into your hips. It's a pretty intense pose for a lot of people. So do the best you can. Be kind and careful to your body. Breathe in your hips if you'd like. You can then rock right to left a little bit, releasing. Ready, go ahead and bring the head up. Slowly walk your hands towards the knee. And we'll slide that leg back onto your knees. And it usually feels really good to come into a downward dog. So let's go ahead and do that. Curl the toes under, lift the hips up. Go ahead and walk it out. You can even do a little twist. Some twisting by bringing one knee in. Up and down, and then we'll go into the other side. So when you're ready, slide the opposite knee forward, again keeping it straight or externally rotating it, lifting the back knee up, sliding it back, coming to your fingertips, lengthening up as you inhale, and then when you're ready, walk those hands forward,
drop the elbows down and relax the head towards the ground. Again, use any props that are necessary for support if you'd like, and breathe deeply. In and out of your nose. Allow your hips to release. Feel free at any time to press the foot on the floor, lift the knee up, slide it back further, allowing the knees to release further. Feel free to rotate right to left, easing into the pose. When you're ready, go ahead and slowly come up to your hands. Remove any props out of the way. Slide that leg back. And come into your downward dog. Go ahead and walk it out. Do the twist. Heels up and down. Back to your knees, and let's rest in child pose. So widening your knees, bringing the head to the floor, resting the arms behind you. Hands by the knees, slowly push it up. Come on to our buttocks. Slowly come down to your backs. Roll down gently. Bringing the feet towards the buttocks. Hands next to the side bodies, rolling the shoulders under, pulling your belly in, engaging your glutes, lifting up through the hips. Into your bridge pose, pushing down firmly and gently, pushing forward through the quads, down through the feet, breathing deeply. Nice opening for the hips, the quads, release for the spine. Exhale, hips down. And then let's bring the knees in towards each other. Give them a gentle squeeze. Rotating the knees in circles. One direction. And then in the other direction. Good. Nice release for the back. All right, let's do a little twisting again. Arms out to the sides, knees into the chest, palms down. Let's take a deep breath. Exhale, both knees to one side, one elbow, shoulders remain on the ground, gazes upwards. Inhale, back up. And then exhale, both knees to the other elbow. And inhale, back up. Okay, hands around the knees, let's rotate the feet around the ankles. In both directions. Ease your toes, point and flex your feet. And bring your feet to the floor. Do a lower spine twist by extending one leg out, bringing the opposite foot to the thigh gently, hand to the knee, opposite hand to the knee, opposite arm out. Take a deep breath. Push your hand down as we twist to the side. Relax the shoulder to the ground. Taking long, deep breaths. Inhale back up. Let's switch those legs, switch the arms. Lengthen through the opposite leg. Place the foot on the thigh gently. Opposite arm on the thigh. And the arm extended out. Press it down as we twist. Shoulder remains on the floor. Relax your jaws and throats. Inhale back up. And let's bring both knees one last time. Give them a squeeze. And then bring the feet to the floor. Lengthen one leg out through the heel, out through the hip, and place it on the floor. Lengthen the other leg out through the heel, out through the hip, and place it on the floor. Reach the arms overhead, taking a nice deep breath. And then relax the feet. And let's reach the arms up. Release the elbows to the floor. And let's rotate those hands around the wrists. One way. And then the other way. Open and close your hands. And then relax the hands to the sides, palms up. Rolling the tailbone under. Wiggling around, getting comfy, and taking a few moments for our relaxation pose. Relax the jaw, your throats, and your facial muscles. Release the tongue away from the roof of the mouth, allowing your soft palates to lift up towards the crown of your heads. Relax your scalps and allow your breath to flow freely and effortlessly in and out of your nose. Allowing each and every muscle to completely relax. Letting your bones feel heavy. Mind begins to wander, follow your breath, in and out of your nose. Welcome to slowly begin to deepen your breath. Wiggle your fingers and toes, bringing more breath back into your body. Sweep the arms overhead, stretch tall. And exhale as you bend your knees, bringing the arms back to the sides. Let's roll to our right. One side, rest for a few breaths. And then slowly push your bodies up. Bring yourselves to a seated position. And just ending our practice, always taking a few moments for yourselves, okay? So bring your hands to the heart. Take a few breaths and just notice your body. How it's feeling, where you're at, in your mind, emotionally, without judgment, just noticing.
I bow down to your divine souls. Namaste. Thank you once again for joining me today. Have a wonderful week. Have a great Monday, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.